Good evening and thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Mr. Marshall and I'm the band director here at Milwaukee Lutheran. And I want to thank you so much for joining us this way for our boosters meeting for September. Usually we meet here in the band room and have a lively discussion on the matters of what the music boosters deal with. And it's sad that that's not possible right now, but I'm glad that we have chosen this as a good option to relay that information until we can meet once again. The Music Boosters is a great entity to be a part of here at Milwaukee Lutheran because everything that the Music Boosters does is to ensure that music can continue here at Milwaukee Lutheran, whether it's in the band room or in the choir room. And so it's such a great opportunity for you as parents to join in and ensure that your children have a good quality music education here at Milwaukee Lutheran. Predominantly, the focus of the Music Boosters is to fundraise. And our major fundraiser happens to be the craft fair. And there'll be more information coming soon via email regarding the craft fair from Mrs. Schley, who happens to be one of our English teachers and also a parent here at Milwaukee Lutheran. Along with that, then we have about three or four other fundraisers around the school year in which funds can be raised with student help and with your help to help make sure that we are able to provide new equipment, hire people to come in and help out for clinics, or even better, to help kids out for their tours. And so be on the lookout for those other fundraisers to be starting up relatively soon. The Music Boosters has had a long history here at Milwaukee Lutheran. As long as I've been here, which is now my fourth year, the interactions that I've had with the people that at these meetings have always been something of positivity and just the love and wanting to make sure that music happens. And so it's just an honor to have a board that is helpful and always willing to help out. And this year we're looking for somebody interested in being a vice president. So if you are curious about that, please reach out to me and then I will give you send your information on to our president, the Music Boosters president, Mr. Marcos Everett, who happens to be a father of one of our band students, Aaron Everett, who's in a symphonic band. And so you'll be able to help out right away being in that case too. With our craft fair, we're also looking for some people who are interested in helping. We have two phenomenal booster parents that are graduating this year with their children. And so they are in charge of certain aspects of that craft fair that we need a parent to fill in. And so if you're somebody that likes to do baking, we're looking for somebody that's willing to shadow our bake sale parent to help out. And if you're somebody who likes to do raffles and get prizes, then we're also looking for somebody to help out and shadow that person too. And then lastly, actually, as I talk about this, we do need somebody that's willing to shadow kind of just the whole entire thing. Wonderful Stamps does a great job. Her son is a trumpet player and a singer, and he's still here for a couple more years, but it'd be nice to get somebody in the works to be prepared to go and fill that position as Wonderful will be graduating with O'Neill. So please continue to watch on to this with these videos as Mr. Daniels talks about the choir program and I talk about the band program for this school year. So thank you so much and God's blessings.
Good evening, everybody. It is the new year, and we are presently struggling. Well, I guess I'll say I am struggling right now with how this whole process looks Choir has not been approved right now, so we are waiting on Cole and other people from the association to let us know how it will look for choir. So just a little nerve-wracking at this point in time, but God knows, and that's the key. We trust the Lord with all of our heart. We lean not to our own understanding. That's the tough part. In all of our ways, acknowledge Him, and He shall direct our path. He shall make our path straight. So just waiting for God to reveal that, and then we'll walk in it. But I'm excited that some students will come in on Tuesday. Don't know what it's going to look like, but we will see at that point. Thank you all so much for once again being a part of the Music Boosters and being willing to help us out. We don't know anything about choir tours or anything of that sort. But as soon as we find out some of that information, we'll be able to share that with you all. So I just want to thank you all for being a part of the Music Boosters. And I look forward to however God's going to use us all together this year. Thank you so much. And on behalf of Harold and myself, we just want to thank you and look forward to being able to sit down with you all. God bless. Bye-bye.
I'm Mr. Marshall, and I'm the band director once again. And as Mr. Daniels said in his choir report, what a blessing we have to be able to do music, but we just don't know the answers. And I really wish Jesus was the answer, because that would make a lot of things easier for us. For the band department, we have been cleared to play here in the band room. And so the band room is set up currently for that. And come Tuesday, we will have students in here playing in one of our many groups that we have. We've also been cleared, if we need to and we want to, it's a nice day, we will go outside and enjoy playing outside and having that fresh air, just as we hope our choir friends can do too. I'm a numbers guy, and if you have been here as long as I've been here, I always talk about how much the band has grown and how much it has stabilized. And that wasn't the case when I came on years ago. And so I'm proud to report that the band is pretty much steady. We have 30 kids in symphonic band, which is a great number. That's been about normal, usual for us. We have about 22 kids in concert band, and we have about 22 kids in Red Knight band, which is just fabulous. And those kids want to play and are looking forward to playing. Our drum lines, we also have two drum lines, and those are pretty full too. And we have beginners and we have advanced, and that's rather exciting to go. And we'll be good for when we are doing our A and B hybrid schedules and all of the classes to be able to do that. And then what I call my pet project, my music appreciation class, has just blossomed. We're now in the third semester of it. And this year we've got a good portion of kids that have signed up for it. And just the interactions that I've had over Schoology have been very good when it comes to that class. So I'm just super blessed with the students that we have in the band program, and I'm just super blessed with just all that's going on in the bands for that. To kind of echo off of what Mr. Daniels stated when it came to tour, this is the band's off season. We only tour every 2 years, and so this is our off year. Last year we were supposed to tour down to New Orleans, and that got canceled. While frustrating and upset that was, I'm glad we did it, as we would have gotten down there and the lockdowns would have started. So I'm glad that wasn't the case for us. We've been reimbursed about 60% of what we've paid to the tour company, which with talking to fellow colleagues around the nation, that was actually pretty good. Some of my colleagues and friends didn't get any reimbursements, or they were given a credit and they have no idea if they're ever going to be able to use that credit. So I'm pretty happy with that. We're waiting for some more money to come back to us from the tour company. And so I really think that we should continue on with using this tour company or a tour company when it comes to planning the band tours, maybe even the choir tours, as it was really easy. It was very simple, and it made life a little less stressful for myself and for those around us too, because we knew exactly what all we had to deal with was give them the money, show up, and go. So I feel like that's something that we should continue on in the future. And in previous years too, a tour company was used for the band program. And lastly, I don't know what the tours are gonna look like in the future. Actually, that's a discussion that we're having right now with the choir, Mr. Daniel and I, along with the association band directors and choir directors at Lake Country Lutheran and at Martin Luther. It's something that I started to talk to them about, as we all have fears, we all have worries, we have no idea how it's going to look. And so being able to discuss that with like minds is always a great thing. And so next year when we go on tour, if we were to go on tour, which would be to down to Florida to march at Disney World, we don't know how that's gonna look. Can we take go on a bus and go for 19 hours on a bus and feel safe? Are there going to be people interested in going on tour? Will Disney and Universal be allowing people to march through their parks? And so those are just questions that we all have, questions that we don't, answers that we don't know. And so that's, it's just a thing of mine that we're not sure about. So that's my report. I pray that as we go through this school year, and I know Mr. Daniels does too, that we're able to be able to provide a quality music education for your child or children, that they are able to enjoy music if they've never had music before, that they're able to begin to enjoy it, and then they stick on and they stay with it too. That's always our hope, is whatever level of choir or band they are in, that they continue on from here. If you be willing to pray with me right now as we close up our meeting for tonight, and more details will be in the email provided that goes with this video. So please pray with me. Dear gracious and heavenly Father, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you for what Milwaukee Lutheran has to offer for us, Lord. And while we don't know all the answers to allow us to be able to do things, Lord, we know that you'd know those answers. And we pray, Lord, that those answers can be provided to us, that we can be safe as we play or as we sing, Lord, and that we are able to just do the mission that we have here at Milwaukee Lutheran, which is to teach lives, teach about Jesus, and then go from there, Lord. Be with all of us as we are at home, and be with our worries and our fears, that we can turn to you, Lord, for guidance and support, and be able to just overcome those, Lord, and ask you for that guidance. And as we prepare here at Milwaukee Lutheran to return to in-person teaching, that we can all stay safe, that we can all stay free from illnesses and COVID, Lord, and that teaching can happen, and that students can feel safe and loved, and enjoy their time here. It's all this we ask in your glorious name. Amen. God's blessings. We hope to hear from you soon.